Websites, social networks, podcasting apps, that guy from Star Trek.
Oh my.
Every day we hear about another big player joining the Fediverse, but what does that mean? Today, on the very first episode of the Fediverse Files, we are going to explain the Fediverse to you and show you it's not as complex as it sounds. In fact, you might already be on it without even knowing it. In simple terms, the Fediverse is a network of websites that interact with each other through a shared protocol. Fediverse is a mashup of two words, federate and universe. To federate means to form an alliance. So the Fediverse is really an alliance of smaller websites or apps that federate content with each other. It's a federated universe. This network is decentralized, meaning no single company controls it and users have control over their own data. Some of these websites or instances are run by corporations while others are run by individuals. Some may have thousands of users, others have just a few. Now, each of these websites has their own rules and local feeds, but users on one site can easily interact with users on another site because they're using the same protocol, an open source tool that connects websites into one global network. The most popular Fediverse protocol is ActivityPub, which you might have heard of because it powers apps like Mastodon, but it also powers Friendica, PixelFed, Limmy, Ghost, PeerTube, Threads is on it. It's extremely popular. So when you publish a post on one website, it gets federated to all of your followers on other websites that use the same protocol. They can like, share, or comment on your post as if it was on the same website they were on. That's the magic of federation.
An instance is what we call a server with ActivityPub installed.
No singing. This is not a musical. This is not a musical tutorial. Now, if the Fediverse is hard to imagine, that's okay. The terminology sounds pretty abstract, so let's simplify it a bit by thinking about something we all use on a daily basis. Let's talk about email, which, pause for dramatic effect, is a federated system. Email's federated. When you sign up for an email service like Gmail, you can still send messages to users on other servers, whether they're on Hotmail or Yahoo, it doesn't matter. Imagine how weird it would be if you couldn't send your email to someone else. That's what the Fediverse is trying to solve. In the Fediverse, we use protocols like ActivityPub. In email, the federated system is made possible through protocols like SMTP or IMAP, which have both been around for about 40 years. In that decentralized system, email users can still interact with each other, but admins of an email server can't edit or delete emails on another server. That would be weird. So if my email admins notice a ton of spam coming from another server, they can either block that individual user or they can block that whole server. If that server is sending too much spam, it's a problematic server. You can defederate from that server so you're no longer hit with the spam until they clean up their act. That's exactly how moderation works on the Fediverse too. A Mastodon instance can defederate from another instance if there's too much spam or unwanted content.
Oh, wow.
Now, when you think about it a little more, email addresses and Fediverse handles are the same too. When you join an email client, the first thing you do is pick a username that's available on that client. So you picked a client, you pick a username. Maybe you have to add some numbers to it to make it unique. If someone already has user@gmail.com, you could be user23@gmail.com or hotuser23@hotmail.com. On the Fediverse, it's the same system. The first thing you do is you pick your server and then you pick your new username that's available on that server. So your Fediverse handle is going to look almost exactly like an email handle. It's going to be username@server. @docpop@mastodon.social, @johnmastodon@joinmastodon.org. You get the idea. When I mention the Fediverse, the first thing some folks might think about is Mastodon. Mastodon is a decentralized microblogging platform similar to Twitter. If you're looking for a Twitter alternative, this is probably the one you've heard of. It's one of the largest applications on the Fediverse, but Mastodon is not the Fediverse.
Mastodon is not the Fediverse.
Okay, I know I said there's no more musical interjections, but that was pretty dope. There are many applications out there that use ActivityPub, and more are coming every day. This is where things get really cool. You could be an active user on PixelFed, which is a decentralized photo sharing platform, and you could still follow and interact with folks on Mastodon from your PixelFed account. This is the magic of the Fediverse. It's like being able to comment on a YouTube account while you're signed in and using Instagram. Now, the Fediverse isn't just for social media. Even blogs and websites can be federated. For example, On my personal site, I installed a free plugin called ActivityPub for WordPress. Once I turned it on, it created an instance of my website that people could follow and interact with from the Fediverse. If someone is following my site through a platform like Mastodon, they can see my post and leave a comment, which then shows up as a comment on my original blog post, all from Mastodon. They don't need to create an account on my site to leave a comment on my site. You don't have to set up a new server or anything. It's like magic. It's so freaking cool. And just like email, you can message me on the Fediverse through that handle I mentioned earlier, at docpop@mastodon.social. If you have any questions or suggestions for future episodes, we'd love to hear it. My name is Doc. I've been blogging for 20 years. Before that, I was making zines on Xerox printers and mailing them to people around the world and trading zines. I am extremely excited about creating stuff and sharing it with people and getting stuff back and finding out what other people are working on. This started with blogging and social media. I was an early user of Twitter. I was an early user of Instagram. I hosted one of the very first real world Instagram meetups. I'm extremely passionate about social media and about the connections we can make through it. And I'm excited that the promise of the open web and these connections is coming back. We're tearing down these wild silos. Where's my hammer and sickle? The Fediverse is really awesome, and I'm extremely excited to see what becomes of it. So stay tuned for more episodes of the Fediverse Files, where we're going to dive in deeper. We're going to talk to experts about ActivityPub, about connecting your WordPress website, and just about what the web could be like. In the comments below, let us know, what was the first thing you thought of when you heard the term Fediverse? Was it Bubba Fett? Was it an entire theme park only filled with Bubba Fett? The Fediverse? Disney, call me.
After this, I owe you nothing.